In this video, I'll show the CMOS implementation of NAND and NOR and OR logic gates and the analysis of these gates using various SPICE tools. In case anyone needs a refresher on logic gates, here's the various gates I'll be discussing and their truth tables. And just for completeness sake, here's the other logic gates, exclusive OR, exclusive NOR, and NOT. The first SPICE tool I'll be using is LTSpice, which is available for Windows and Mac. With LTSpice, you can graphically create your circuit. When I started using SPICE, I used a VAX 11780 mainframe, and there weren't any WYSIWYG circuit design tools. This is a big improvement. Notice that the NMOS and PMOS transistors have a line in the middle with an arrow. This is the bulk or body line. In terms of SPICE, it doesn't change the results if you don't connect the bulk to something, but you will get a warning about nodes not connecting to anything. However, in a real-life circuit, the bulk should be connected to something to prevent latch-up, which could ruin the device. In most cases, the PMOS bulk should be connected to VDD, and the NMOS bulk should be connected to ground. Or the bulk could be connected to the source of the transistor. This is a CMOS NAND logic gate. To get a detailed description of how these circuits work, view my other videos on NANDs and NORs. Each element can be edited to adjust the parameters. A pulse source should really not have a zero T rise and T fall. SPICE knows this, so it uses a default value instead. You should probably make it something like 1 nanosecond. With LTSpice, you can graphically see the inputs A and B and the output F. Notice that because of the T rise and T fall parameters that SPICE chose by default, A and B have rather big slope regions. The output F therefore has little spikes and big slope regions as the inputs change state. Here's a CMOS NOR gate. Here's a simple CMOS AND gate. The idea of this came from a viewer who had an interesting comment on my NAND video in which he proposed switching the PMOS and NMOS transistors in the NAND circuit. Assuming he meant keep the PMOS in parallel and the NMOS in series, an AND is what you would get. If he meant keep the schematic exactly the same but switch PMOS and NMOS, then you get an OR gate. These two circuits aren't the way CMOS ANDs and ORs are normally done, and aren't the best design. Usually a CMOS AND is created by using a NAND with an inverter, which is called a NOT. I circled the inverter with the mouse pointer. Similarly, a CMOS OR is a NOR with a NOT. I believe the reason for the difference in design is that by just switching the PMOS and NMOS, the output doesn't hit the rails, meaning it doesn't hit VDD and ground. This can result in poor quality outputs, and since these circuits are usually cascaded, poor outputs become poor inputs. Here's the two versions of AND compared. By the way, with LTSpice, if your circuit has an associated .plt file, the graphical traces are already set up according to what's in the PLT file. If you don't have a PLT file for your circuit, you can select the lines you want to show. Also, with LTSpice, instead of inputting the circuit graphically, you can type in the SPICE circuit manually. Here's the SPICE files for all the circuits discussed. The first two are the NAND and NOR, the second two are the simpler but inferior AND and OR, and the last two are the better AND and OR. Now I'll discuss some UNIX or Linux SPICE tools. The first is Oregano. With Oregano, you can graphically create the circuit and view the graphical traces just like with LTSpice. By default, Oregano uses GNU cap to do the circuit analysis, but ngspice can be selected instead. The graph doesn't quite look as good, but might be more accurate. Next, I'll use ngspice manually. This is just like the output I got on the VAX mainframe. And here's the SPICE circuit that was used. Next, I'll use SPICE 2G.6. And here's the SPICE circuit used. Note, if you're using a SPICE version older than free, you can't use letters in your node names. You have to use just numbers, and ground has to be zero. With Nutmeg, you can get a plot of the traces, but they're not as good as the others. There are many other SPICE tools. However you do it, you'll find SPICE is a very useful tool.